Good morning, students. I am your subject teacher of language, Ms. Prabhjeet Kaur. As you all are aware of the circumstances we are going through, so let not waste any time and get started. I will try my level best to guide you through these learning videos. Today, we will start with chapter 25, the uses of present and past tense, given in page number 75 of your book. Children, as you all have gone through the lesson, tenses introduction in class 6, so I hope you all must be aware of it. But still, starting with a little recap, I would like to recall what is a tense. In this slide, we see what is a tense. The time of an action is known as tense. When a particular work is being done, the time is known as tense. The time, whether it is past, present or future, that is called a tense. How many types of tenses are there? They are 3 in number as given in the diagram: present tense, past tense and future tense. And again, they are further divided into the sub points, which we will see into the next slide. Further division of tenses. Here we see in this diagram, tenses are divided into 3 forms, that is present, past and future. And again, each of them are divided into simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. Now, let us see first the present. So, present will become simple present tense. Then, present continuous tense. Then comes in number 3, present perfect tense. And in number 4, present perfect continuous tense. Number 1 of past, we see simple past tense. Then comes past continuous tense. Then is past perfect tense. And the last is past perfect continuous tense. Same with the future tense. That is simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, future perfect continuous tense. So children, here we see 4 in simple, 4 in past and 4 in future. So all together, how many types of tenses are there? They are 12 in number. So these all points are all you can say the steps: simple, present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. Like these, all the sequence should be in your mind. So you have to learn it by heart very nicely so that you don't make mistake in tenses. And children, you also need to remember like these diagrams or this chart, particularly you have to copy down in your single lined notebook. So these forms also need to be written: simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. All the forms, four forms under each tense. That is, first you'll write tense, then you'll give 3 lines for the present, past and future, and then you will divide present into 4 forms, past into 4 forms and future into 4 forms. So that is it, what you have to copy down in your single lined notebook. Children, let me just make you aware of what we are reading. We are here specially reading about the uses of the present and the past tense, how to imply them, how to use them, the present and the past tense. So first we will look at the present tense. So here is a slide for the present tense. In present tense, you can see, as explained to you earlier in the previous diagram. So here we will see present tense. Present is divided into simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. So let us look into little detail about each of them. Under present tense, there is a sub point called simple present tense. Now let us look at some rules for simple present tense. Do and does. Now here do and does doesn't mean that you have to imply only do and does in a statement, then only it will become a simple present tense. Here do and does means or shows the habitual action, the regularity and the general truths all come under it. So for A, now we'll see number A here, to express a habitual action. For example, if I say he drinks tea every morning. He is the subject over here. Drinks is the verb over here. Tea every morning. Now here, he and drinks. Why drinks over here is written? Why not drink, he drink? Why? Because here he is singular. The subject is singular. So the verb here will also be singular. According to the subject, the verb will also be singular. That's why we have added over here S to drink. So it becomes drinks. So he drinks, what he is drinking? Tea. He is drinking tea. Here in the picture also you can see, he is drinking tea. So he drinks tea every morning. Here every is also showing that it is a particular habit a person is doing. That is, every morning means each and every morning he is drinking tea. So it is showing a habitual action. Let us see the second example. I do not go to my office on Fridays. Here a person is saying that he never goes to his office on Fridays. Whether the week after week or a month after month, you can say, each and every week he is saying that on Fridays he regularly don't go to office. That is his regularity. Okay. So next is number B, to express general truth, or we can say universal truth. For example, we'll see number one, the sun rises in the east. Children, if I say the sun rises in the west, how many of you will agree? Of course, no one will agree, because this is a general truth. We cannot decline it. In number two, if we see honey is sweet, here is the helping verb which we are using. And in the above example, that is example one of general truth, we'll see rises, that is also a verb. Okay, here we see in number two, honey is sweet. So we cannot say honey is bitter. That is a general truth we are seeing. In this slide we see again the continuation of the simple present tense rules. So here number C, we see in exclamatory sentence, wherever it begins with here and there, we express what is taking place in the present. So example, if we say with here and there, we have to make sentence. For example, number one, here comes the bus. So here we see we are using over here, and with an exclamation mark we are saying it's a sudden information that here comes the bus. So comes here is the verb, and here we are implying with an exclamation mark, which shows that the action is taking place in the present. Second example, we see there she goes. This is the present, simple present example of it. Like right now she is going, so there she goes. Okay, now come to number D, to express any future event that is a part of a fixed timetable or fixed program. Of course, suppose any timetable is fixed of a train or of a flight, or any fixed program is there which you need to express, that is a future event. Okay, but it is having a fixed timetable. So that you can consider as a simple present tense. Like For example, the next flight is at 7 tomorrow morning. So we are talking about the future timetable of a program, we can say, a fixed program we are talking about, that the flight is at 7 only in the morning. So that we are talking about in the present with the usage of is over here. So we can understand that this tense sentence is in the simple present form. Second example is the game starts at 2 o'clock. So this also we can say it is a part of a timetable which is fixed. So this part is also, this sentence is also simple present tense, in simple present tense. So number E we come, broadcasting. Now whenever children we see commentaries on any of the sporting events or any commentaries on the television we see based on cricket or wrestling, anything. So we see that broadcasting is also in the simple present sense. For example, Saurabh now rushes forward and deals a heavy blow to Rustam. So here we see that Saurabh and Rustam both are the name of a person. So he rushes. Rushes, of course, this is showing an action. Deals shows an action. So here it is showing that the broadcasting is going on, the commentary is going out, that like he is right now doing what, that particularly is being said, but it is not in continuous form because it is continuing. The live commentary sometimes we see they are in continuous form, but till then they don't say in continuous form, rather they say it in simple present tense. In this slide we see the second form of present tense, that is present continuous tense. Children, we have already studied the first form, that is simple present. So this is the second form, that is present continuous. By the name itself we can guess, continuous means the thing which is in continuation. So here we generally use is, am, are plus V1, that is verb's first form, plus ing. Under is we can see the subjects given over here, he, she, it, Ria. Children, did you notice one thing? All the subjects are singular. They are singular in nature. So with is, we always use this type of formation. Like for example, I'll say, she is dancing. So this is a continuous form. It is showing that with the use of is, I am using the subject she and verb 1, that is dance, plus ing form. So she is dancing. With am, we see we generally use I. We never use with any other subject like you am or we am. We always use I am. Like for example, I say I am studying. So here it is showing the continuous form that I am still studying. Okay, now let's come to R, under which we can see you, we, they and I. These subjects are plural in nature. So with R we always use you are dancing, we are singing. So this is in continuous form that we are still singing. Okay, and for the V1 I said that dancing is there, so V1 will be dance plus ing will become dancing. Here V1 will be sing plus ing will become singing. So children, when do we use present continuous tense? We use present continuous tense when there is an ongoing activity which is going in the present and which is in motion. That also we need to take care of, which is in motion at the present time, which is going on. Let us go through some examples of the present continuous form. Number A, action going at time of speaking. Right, whenever we are, suppose we are talking and that time only the action is taking place. For example, I am talking to you. So right now when I am talking, now I am talking to you. So the action is going at the time when I am speaking. So the second example we can look is, the girls are dancing beautifully. Children, always keep in mind, you all always see the verb which is being used over here. Verb plays a very important role in tenses. Very important. Until and unless you carefully notice that what is being given in the verb, so you cannot do it. So you have to be very clear with your verb form. So come to number B, for a temporary action which may not happen the time of action. Right now, suppose I am saying something, but it is in a temporary action. It may not happen when I am doing that action. So like for example, I say I am reading Jungle Book. Right now I am not reading, but I am going through it. So that we can give example of a simple continuous form, this sentence. So come to number C, the action that has been arranged. Now one action which is being arranged in the near future, that also we can say as present continuous tense. Like for example, like I'll say someone that right now I'm saying I am going to cinema tonight, or I'm going to see a cinema tonight. So that is, I'm going to see, I have not completed yet, it will be taking place in near future, but it has been already arranged. So I am saying that in present continuous form. Okay, in this slide children, we'll come across present perfect tense, that is the third form of present tense. First we learnt simple present tense, then we learnt the rules of present continuous tense. Now we'll be learning present perfect tense. So in this tense children, has or have plus V3 we use, that is the verb's third form. Under has, we see whenever we use has is used for always singular subjects. For example, we use she has, he has, it has. Okay, and when we use have, with have we use plural subjects. For example, they have, we have, you have. Verb 3 is done, like do, we say, we never say do, we won't write over here do. He, like here I say she has do. No, she has done. So this is the way how we say in present perfect tense. So we use present perfect tense whenever we finish an action in recent time or in present time, we generally use this tense. That is present perfect tense. Let us look at some examples of present perfect tense, which is the third form of present tense. So number A, to indicate complete activities in the immediate past. Just now the activity has completed. So we will use mostly over here just. For example, that he has just done this work, means immediately he has completed this work, now only. So the example, the next example we see is just similar, like they have just gone out. Right now only this activity or this action has been done, this action just now had completed. So immediate past, just now. So here we use mostly just. In the children, the diagram also given here, you can just notice that here the work has started from the past and it is still continuing till the present. So in number B we see, to express past action whose time is not given. Here we see, for example, Mr. Sundar has been to England. That means that the time, the definite time when he has been to England, that is not given, but here only the past action is given, but the time is not mentioned. In the next, number C, we see to describe past events when we think more of their effect in the present than of the action itself. We don't focus on the action more, rather we think of their effect in the present. For example, we see over here, like Gopi has eaten all the biscuits. Now, we are not thinking that Gopi had eaten. Why? We are thinking that there are no biscuits left only. There aren't any left. So, they are thinking about the present. Rather than focusing on the past, we are thinking about the present. One more example if I give, like I have cut my finger. But we are not focusing on how I have cut my finger, but I am focusing on like it is bleeding right now. So, this type of examples we give when we think more of the effect in the present than the action. Now, in number D, we see that an action beginning at some time in the past and continuing till present. Whatever had already completed in the past, you will see the action is still continuing and it is continuing till the present. Like mostly we use two words which we have often heard, often with since and for. Mostly we use it with since and for. For example, if I give, I have known him for a long time. So, from past I know him, but till now I know that person. So, I have known him for a long time. So, here I am using for showing that the action started in the past and still it is continuing. Or I can give an example like he has been ill since last week. From that time onwards he was ill and till now he is ill. So, he has been ill since last week. So, here we come to the fourth point of the present tense, that is present perfect continuous tense. Let me remind you children, we have already done the three forms under present tense, that is simple present, present continuous, present perfect. Now, we are going with present perfect continuous tense. In this, under this we write has been, have been, plus V1, that is verb's first form, plus ing, plus since or for. So, the use of since. When do we use since? We use since for a particular point of time. For example, if we say since 10 o'clock, or if we say for example, they have been playing since 10 o'clock. Or since childhood, that is saying a particular point of time. And when do we use for? For is used for the duration or a particular period of time. For example, we say for 2 hours, for 20 minutes, or we can also say, for example, he has been sleeping for 5 hours, means he is still sleeping. This also shows that it is in a continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense. In simple words, we can say, what is a present perfect continuous tense? It is an activity which began in the past and is still continuing, which we can see with the help of the diagram given over here. It shows it started from the past and it is still continuing in the present. Let us look into the examples of present perfect continuous tense, which is the fourth form of present tense. Before we have done number 1 simple present, number 2 present continuous, number 3 present perfect. Now we are going with the fourth, present perfect continuous. So, here we see number A, to describe an action which began at some time in the past and is still continuing. Means the action had already started in the past, but we see it is still continuing in the present. For example, let us see, he have, here we are using he have. With have, we are using singular subject, that is he. So, he have been riding a bicycle for 2 hours. Means for 2 hours he has been riding and still now it is continuing. Again here one example is given, Ramesh has been working since 8 a.m. From 8 a.m. Ramesh is working and till now he is continuing his work. So the action started somewhere in past, but it's still continuing. In the second example, we see that this tense is also used for an action already finished. They are talking about an action, an activity which had already completed, which had already finished. Now what happens in these cases, the continuity of the activity or action is emphasized. How it is emphasized? By the explanation of something. Now a question has been put to you, like, why are you so late? So what is the answer to it? I have been playing in the garden. So here already the action has completed, but an explanation of this thing you have to give. So that will be in the present perfect continuous tense. So the second example we see here is, why are your clothes so wet? So here what kind of explanation is given? An explanation is given, I have been watering the plants. So now we come to an end of the present form, the tenses which comes under the present form. Now the past part is left, which we'll do in the next class. And till now we have learnt all the four tenses, that is sub tenses, under the present form. In the next class we'll study about the past. So children, you need to copy the tense chart in your classwork or notebook, that is single rule copy from slide 4. First what you need to write is the tense, and then how many parts? Present, past and future, and under that four subdivisions of each, that you need to write. And you have to go through the entire chapter which has been taught to you right now clearly and completely.